from Emin Primary School. I'm Kosoko, 11 years old, primary 5, also from Emin Primary School.
Now we'll go onwards. Careless. Chapter 7.
Double and triple integration. So we have already used three methods for this question, right?
Yep. So this time will be the fourth method.
Right. Yes. So for these, there are three methods. Two of them are Cartesian. One is
polar.
Yes.
This time is still Cartesian, but unlike last time was splitting into three parts. Unlike last time, this time I'm going to use the Y first and X.
Yes. So first we have this semicircle I.
Yeah.
Next, we have this
I, but
part of a circle.
Remember this I, now the green part is this black part still?
Yes. So right now, we're actually just looking at the black parts.
Also, and the black line which is the y axis splits to
okay.
Into three parts.
One part, two part, three part.
So now, let me tell you. Now this x equals whatever is no use, right?
Yeah.
So now we'll use y equals.
We'll change this into y equals what?
2 minus square root 2 minus y square. I mean 2 minus x squared. Negative square root 2 minus x squared.
So right now I'll be starting with method 4.
Yeah, which is the last method, right? But usually you just use three methods, right?
Yeah.
But the fourth method, which is the hardest method. And the question is, double integral the region which is x squared plus y squared is smaller or equals to 2. X minus 1 bracket squared plus y squared is bigger or equal to 1. And the integral which is x plus y then is respect to x and y.
So, first respect to y.
Yup.
We have that part I.
Yeah, we're still gonna split into three parts, right?
Of course.
Correct.
Like this, is it right?
Yes.
Then after that, what happens?
So,
we'll just write this as? A plus B plus C, okay?
Yeah.
So first, for part A. Part A. What do you think would this be? So for part A,
of course, double integral first.
Remember, double integral change it into iterated integral.
Yup.
So from Y, which is all the way from this up. Be like this. then x from here go that way will be the
so if from negative square root of 0
like this, is it right?
Yeah.
Then after that, so from this, what can you cancel out? Okay, we cancel out.
The y, because it's an odd function. Right?
Yeah. Like this.
Yeah.
And then after that, sub them in.
Yeah.
Here and then, what happens? Why can't I just put a 2 there?
Because you can't put the...
Why can't I put a 2 here?
Because it's a constant.
Yes.
Constant, we don't care.
So next for this, what would you realize? Here is half, here is 1, right?
1, yes.
What I meant is the power.
Even though this is an odd function, but you can't change it to 0 because that is wrong, because that it's not
an odd.
Wait, it is an odd function. It's not
symmetric.
Yeah. It is odd, but it's not symmetrical, okay? So if we just 1, it's enough already. But for the second and third part, 1 alone is not enough.
So this is for part A, right?
Yeah.
So at this part, we can put it as?
So here we will have the negative square root 2 over 3.
4 square root 2 over 3, you mean?
Yeah. Negative 5 square root 2 over 3.
Next, we can combine the?
B, C, D, E. F. Actually, there's no F, there's only B and C. A is alone, B and C together.
So for this part, which is here and here, right?
Yup.
So for B, which is from 0 to 1.
Yep.
And here is the from the Y. Here, this curve to up. Which
yes.
Will be the? So this is Y equals?
So.
What is it?
Y will equals to square root 1 minus bracket x minus 1 bracket square error.
like this, right?
Yeah.
So for this part, which will go from
x minus 1 bracket square, square root 2 minus negative x square, right?
Okay. So at this part, what can you have?
So we have
so this is the square root.
Negative square root 2 minus x square. Right?
Yeah. Then what happens? What happens?
So we can't get away the y even though it's an odd function because
this is not symmetric.
So well that's in
but remember we can actually combine that, right?
Yep.
So x will become the xy, right?
Yep.
So xy, that means it'll be so here, can you read it out?
So it's wait, you have a finish.
I come here.
Okay, you come there. You go there. So it is actually x square root 2 minus x square minus x square root 1 minus bracket x minus 1 bracket square plus half bracket 2 times x square bracket times half bracket 1 minus bracket x minus 1 bracket square bracket minus x square root 1 minus bracket x minus 1 bracket square plus square root 2 x plus square root 2 minus x square plus bracket 1 minus bracket x minus 1 bracket square minus
okay, it's alright now. You can start reading over there.
Okay, so actually here a minus not a times, okay.
So right now at this part here, can we cancel it?
Okay.
So okay. This.
That part and this part, this.
Combine.
Yeah. This.
Right.
This combine. Even though it also combines, except for it's the next is combined.
Okay.
So there's two combinations, right?
Yeah. Like this.
Yeah.
Then after that, and this part, we separate them, right?
We could take out the two. We can.
We don't.
Okay, even though we can. It's a can, but we just don't want to do that.
So for this part, we can put the 2x inside the dx, right?
Yes.
Which is going to possibly look like this, right?
Yes.
And then after that, what do you have at the back?
Behind still need to minus. Something's fishy going on. You miss out the negative. Do you know why? Here got a negative, here don't have a negative.
Okay, yes.
That's why I'm saying it's fishy. Something fishy going on again. You gotta get another negative. Actually, I'm just kidding.
Like this?
Something fishy. Actually, nothing fishy. It's just that you hear.
So it can actually separate, right?
Yeah. Then after that.
Then we would?
Separate someone from it.
So is it right for the first part?
Yeah.
So I'll just write it like this because then I want to integrate them all at once, okay?
Okay.
So after that, here, put that in, right?
Yeah.
So for this, but did you know that it is actually something wrong?
Let me say. Why is that one? Yeah. That's why I know why it's that one. Continue. Separate. Then we will put it here.
Did you realize that there's a weird thing here?
Why is it from 0 to 0?
Like, this is it, right?
Yeah.
So for this part, we'll just work it out at that place. Well, we'll calculate out what is that alone, right? So we'll write it in its original form. Like this?
Yes.
So next, for this.
Yeah.
So what will we use? Integral by parts, right?
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah.
And then after that, what happens? Sub in, what happens?
Sub in, so here.
Here. Here is?
So.
Zero, right?
Zero, yes. The low minus two, no need to write zero.
Differentiate, right?
Yep.
So RK will be the
here,
like this.
Okay. Nothing's wrong. I can write your x properly.
So next, for this, what happens?
So here. We were in.
Is this a minus or a plus first?
That become a plus.
No.
Well, I'm kidding. After it become a plus, then it become a minus again.
So I get something like this.
Okay.
So I can put this minus up here, right?
Yes.
Then I can plus one, minus one. Can I?
Yeah, we could, of course.
Like this, is it right?
Yeah.
Separate.
Yeah, we'll separate to two parts.
Thank you. like this, is it right?
Yes.
Then after that, at this part, what can happen?
So over here,
we'll use the x minus 1, right?
Yes.
What if we use the x minus 1? What do you think happens?
If x minus 1 here becomes, over here become the sine inverse.
Remember, for this,
I'm saying about this just now.
Okay, for this, you change it to x minus 1, then you put it here, right?
Yeah. Something fishy. What about? Wait a second. Shouldn't here be a plus? In a plus. In a plus. Okay.
Then for this, so that's when you can put this, right?
Yeah.
And then that will be the half of it. Am I right?
Correct.
Sine inverse x minus 1, right?
Yes.
Then you start from 0 to 1, right? So when it is?
So when it is.
When it is a zero, it doesn't matter, right?
Yeah.
And remember, when it is a negative, this will become a negative half pi, right?
Yeah.
Negative, negative, positive. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
So this will be the pi over 4, right?
Yes.
So, at this part, we can sub it in.
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah.
And then after that, which is the part at the back in which we calculated it just now, right?
Yes.
So, sub in the 1, what happens? Here is still a negative 4 over 3, right?
Yes.
Sub in 0, what happens?
Wait, where did you get the positive thing?
Then after that, here is
something clippy going on. Something creepy is going on. Wait a second. Here, pi over 2. It's a pi over 2. There's a pi over 2. I need a minus pi over 2. Something fishy. You know it doesn't. I know it's. Oh, here should be a plus. So we need to change it. Because inside is a negative, so outside is a positive.
Okay. So what happens when you start in one?
Do you ever feel like dead?
Yes. Zero?
Yeah.
Like this, right?
Yeah.
So put this in. So this is the answer, right?
Yes.
So for that will be the answer. So can it end here?
Wait, you haven't got the answer yet still? Okay, here I tell them.
So what did you realize for these methods?
The white first is the hardest.
Okay, well, do you mean that it is very complicated?
Yeah.
Which method do you think is the easiest in your opinion?
In my opinion, it's this whole thing minus this part.
Is it easiest?
Yeah.
Okay, I also think that is easy, right?
Yeah.
It only need two parts, but all these others?
Three parts.
Yes.
For the coordinate.
Three parts.
Three parts. There's another Cartesian coordinate, three parts. This one, Y first, also three parts. Three parts, no match for two parts.
Okay, so you mean two parts no match for three parts?
My meaning three parts no match for two parts means three parts harder to solve.
Okay, so for this, are you clear of all of these?
Yes.
So do you have anything to say or ask?
If you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and tune in for more adventures. Take care, Riley.
Okay, so remember, you must choose the right order, the right coordinates,
yes,
and the right way to split them up, right? Right?
Yeah.
So, we'll see you in the next video. Hope you like our video.
Okay.
Thank you for your watching.